back to GMA3. Following a visit to the United Nations, Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky is...
rappers in hip-hop history and his murder, one of pop culture's longest-lasting mysteries.
Impact by Nightline takes a closer look at the investigation into the rapper's murder, as well as Tupac's enduring legacy. Nightline's Ashton Singh spends time with rapper Simba, who says Tupac's imprint on hip-hop is still fresh. Yeah, we're joined now by Ashton Singh. Okay, we have to talk about all of this stuff. Decades after his death, his legacy, very clear. You could see it there in that clip.
Actors, ambassadors for different... first, you know, and you saw it here with Simba rapping bar for bar 27 years later. His legacy is enduring, and the impact that he's had on the greater culture, like, cannot be denied.
Young and so smart. And let's talk about the increased, thought.
Yeah, so there was a raid on who did it, right? And so when it comes to a case like this that's in the hands of the grand jury now, people aren't really holding their breath. When
it felt like it came out of nowhere. So tip
the case that even though people think that they know what happened, it seems to not die.
Ashton Singh, we also have to say it's your first time on the set with us.
Thank you guys for having me. Tupac, the murder of Tupac Shakur, is tackling chronic back pain.
And they've been pumping out classics like this one for about 50 years. We'll hear from Air.
All right, folks, we're back now with Dr. Darian, who is in for Dr. Jan this afternoon. And today, we're talking about psychological stressors at work being linked with an increased risk of heart disease in men. What
can
you tell us?
So this is a new higher levels of stress and more disimbalance between the work that they put out and the compensation that they received. Had almost a
difference between men and women in the workplace and how it affects their health.
You know, there's a lot of theories that can go. Technically, they theoretically were unhealthier than comparative to the women.
I've never said that. Also, we deal with a lot of stress just naturally being women at home with children and families. Yeah.
There's something we can all learn from our peers.
But diet, of course, right?
Diet as well. About the social determinants of health. And when you talk about that,
that disconnect between what you're doing and what you're getting paid, adding to the stress, that is really interesting.
We all need to get paid more.
Darian said it. We all need to get paid more. I just want to make sure that didn't get lost.
Back in a moment.
And up to 20% of the American population has this problem, and so you might need surgical correction.
So you explained it, but what are the symptoms? How would lower abdomen or
sometimes pain, but most often symptoms after you're eating. And so patients will come in with heartburn or chest pain after they eat and ask
prescription for wellness, doctor.
Back pain, one of the most common problems I've seen. Talk about simple tips and tricks in order to make sure that we correct our pain. Everyone's sitting really tall.
He's the tallest on the sofa.
I think Eva has the best posture.
She does. She really does.
Well, like, sit up
you increase like 4 inches.
Yeah,
he's
much taller all of a sudden.
All right, Doc, thank you. And folks, we'd love to hear from you, so hit us up on Instagram.
Down some of the most memorable love songs decade after decade. Hummed along, or you did a little twirl around the dance floor to any number of their hits. Well, ABC's Phil Lipoff sat down with a popular duo for our Prime playlist as they take a look back. I know. Also, you know, like every single one of their songs. Mm-hmm. It's crazy how many of them you know. Our thanks to Phil for that report. And when we come back, hip-hop legend and actor Ice-T.
Ice-T, he has a hip-hop industry and one of the most iconic voices in the game for the past 3 decades.
ABC News contributor Roxy Diaz got to chat with him. Hey, Roxy.
See,
did
you
used to break dance?
Oh, of course. Of course. Do the worm, everything. Spin around.
We need to see this.
Nah, I'm good.
Just a reminder for our viewers, you need to talk with your doctor before getting the flu shot, especially anyone who has an egg allergy or allergy to any of the other ingredients that are in that vaccine.
That's good advice.
And from pushing the pedal to please welcome racing legend Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Dale,
we talk about the book, My Brother-in-Law Will Kill Me If I Don't Talk About the Race. So last Friday, you had an eventful return to NASCAR Xfinity Series Ranch.
It burnt the and go down the pit road and get out. But
so I'm sure all the fans are wanting to know, are they going to see more Lil E on the
absolutely,
track?
Absolutely, yeah. I love driving, and it's hard to give it up entirely. I run about one or every once in a while. Yeah.
Buster gets back on track. Buster was your father's nickname.
This book to your daughters, Isla and Nicole. Have they read it yet? Did they help you write it?
She's sort of connecting to the book. This is our second Buster to one book, and they just want it over and over and ever. And so I was trying to...
Your father and your girls?
I tell you, they're different between the two. Changing all the time. Like, every... It's always an experience, always a new experience.
fun and exhausting. I have a 2-year-old as well.
So. All right. I can relate.
Who also has big emotions. So
that's
this
right.
is a good book for her. Dale, thank you so much for being with us today. And you can get Buster Gets Back on Track Thursday. We'll see you right back here tomorrow. I'm Eva Pilgrim.
I'm DeMarco Morgan.
And I'm Dr. Darian Sutton.
For all of us here at ABC News, including Dale Earnhardt Jr., we thank you so much for watching. And we will see you tomorrow. It's Friday, everybody. Have a good one.
When the day that lies ahead of me seemed impossible to face.